dear students, starting with the next unit, unit number 5, object oriented events. In this unit we will learn about the two lessons, lesson number 1, implementing events in a local class, and lesson number 2, implementing events in local interfaces. So starting with the lesson number 1, implementing events in local class. So before proceeding on to the next topic, which is implementation of how we can implement the event and how it can react to the classes and so on, here I want to discuss about the what are the events. Generally we have studied about the attributes, methods, classes, interfaces. So we have another type of component, and that component is called event. And these events generally can be triggered by the instances of the classes. But the static events can only be called by the class itself. And we can also use this event as an interface components. Now, how it reacts to the instances, how it reacts to the classes? As you can see in this figure, we have a vehicle class and we have the number of instances, car rental company, vehicle registration office and so on. And this class is triggering the event, and this event is passes directly to the car rental company, vehicle registration office and so on. When you develop a class that triggers the event, you do not need to know anything about the class which is handling it. And the triggering class sends a specific message to the all classes, and if required, their instances. So we can consider here is as instances, or you can consider it as a classes. So triggering class. So in this case, this is sender and this is recipient or handler classes. This sender class will send a specific message to the recipient handler classes. In this example, you can see after an instance in the vehicle is created, the instance trigger the event vehicle has been created. For example, this is our rental car company which handle the purchasing of a vehicle. Vehicle registration office class which register the purchase vehicle and so on. So this class sender is created a event vehicle created, and then it will send a message to the all the classes or instances that this event has been happened. Now come to the next topic. In this topic you can see how we can represent the event handling in UML class diagrams. So we have two classes, the local class vehicle and local class rental. In this UML diagram, a dotted arrow is always used as a stereotype pointing from the handling class to the triggering class. So this is a handling class which is handling the event, and this is our triggering class. The event definition and the significant signatures only appear implicitly in the handling class within the handler method. So you can see this is event handler method, own vehicle created. Suppose a rental company is creating a new vehicle. As own vehicle is created, it will execute this instruction and sends an event message to the local class vehicle. So this is called event method, event handler method. The handler method are separated from the other method using the stereotype. You can see this is a double less than and greater than. This is called stereotype. And this is another simple method, display underscore attributes. And this is an event name which is raising in the class. So we have two classes. This is called handling class, and this is called triggering class. In this triggering class, we generally write down the event name in the raising class, and in the handling class, we write down the handler method in the handle class. Now, this is a procedure how to trigger and handle the event. The step number one, define an event in the class. So firstly, we will define an event in a particular class which is called handler class. The syntax for this event is event name, and then class, if you are creating the static events, then we use the class events keyword. Then triggers an event in the class or instance. The syntax is raise event. So in the triggering class, we will raise that event. And then step number 3, define and implement the handler method in the handler class. We will define the method in case of handler class. You can see on vehicle created is a handler method. We have created into the handler class. And the syntax for this is, if you are using as a normal instance method, so we will use as a method only, method for event of. And if you are using the static event, then we will use this class methods. The last number, step number 4, register handler objects or handler class to events at runtime. The syntax for this is set handler. So we have to register the all the handler objects which is raised by the handler class to the events at the runtime. Now come to the next topic, how we can define and triggering events in case of a programming. So this is in syntax, how we can define the raising class, the class keyword, then raising class, and then definition, then event, number of events that you want to create. So this is event name, and then we use the parameter exporting value ev_pr, and the type name. Similarly, implementation of the raising class, raising class, implementation, method name, and then we use the keyword raise event, and then event name. So now you can see this is an example where we are creating a local class vehicle, which is a raising class. So in this class, we will use here the two keywords. When we are defining this class, then we will use the keyword events. And when we will use the implementation part, then we will use the keyword raise event. So this is our raising class. So this is a local vehicle class, which is raising an event vehicle created. Now see in this example program, class, this is local vehicle, and then definition. Generally, we declare the events in case of public section. So we are using here the public section. This is normal constructor, methods, constructor, and then importing. And this is an events keyword vehicle created. Now come to the implementation part. So in this implementation part, generally we define the method. So this is our method constructor, and this is our keyword raise event, and then event name, and the event name is vehicle created, and the method is always ended with the end method. So we are raising the event into the constructor. In the same way, we can also create the instance event or static methods. And these instance events or static methods can be defined within a class to handle the events. And that we can do with the help of event statement. But static methods or static events you can create with the help of class events keyword. Now come to the next topic, handling events. Now in this figure, you can see how we can handle the events, and that is your syntax. That is step number 3. Syntax is class, then handling class, then definition part, and then methods on event name for event name. So we will use here the for event statement, which must specify the event using the for event, and then event name of raising class. So you can see in the previous figure, this was the class which was raising the event LCL vehicle. So here we will use here the for event name of raising class. Of raising class means of local class vehicle or interface. And then we will define the parameters. You can see in this an example program, this is our class LCL rental. So this is our class rental. I have already told you about that. The handling class may be the instance or object or a class. So in my case, this is our class. So local class rental, this is definition, this is handling class. So we will define here the methods. This is our methods on vehicle created method. That means when the event was raised by the vehicle class and the event name was vehicle created, that event would be handled by the car rental company. So on event name means method on vehicle created for event, for which event? For event vehicle underscore created of which class, because there may be one class or more than one classes which is going to generate the events. So we need to specify the particular class here. So we will define here like this one, for event vehicle created of local vehicle class, and then importing is sender, and then class is always ending with the end class. Now come to the next topic, event handler registration. The definition of the handler method only specify how and to which event of which class the method will react. So at the runtime, it need to be determined which possible reaction will actually will take place and when each of these reaction will happen. When triggering instance events, you also have to specify which event the reaction will trigger. So if instance method are set to carry out the reaction, you also have to specify which instance will perform the reaction. So these specifications are collectively called registration. In this figure, you can also see an example. Suppose these are the handling classes and these are the triggering classes. I have already discussed about this one in the previous slide. You can see there may be only single class which is generating the event, or it may be more than one classes which are generating the events for the handling classes. So in the same thing that is described in this figure, you can see we have the number of triggering classes which are generating the events. So this is bus 1, bus 2, truck 1, these are generating the events, and these events can be handled by the potential handlers. So these handlers may be car rental company 1, vehicle registration office, car rental corporation 2. So these are the number of handlers, but here we have to specify which event the reaction will trigger. That means if this is a handling class, it must have to be known prior that this event is generated for this potential handler and which has been generated by the which triggering class. You can see this event is to be handled by this potential handler, and these events, all these events are handled by vehicle registration office, and the car rental corporation 2 is not handling any event. So we need to be specify here which event is generated for which potential handler class. So this is called registration, and generally registration is always carried out using the trigger. Registration means that means each triggering class has to be registered at the handler class, and how we can register by using the registration event handling. So the next topic is related to this one, how we can register event handling. So this in syntax we use the keyword set handler. Events are generally registered using the set handler statement, and registration is only active at the program runtime. How we can define it? Set handler, then reference handler name with the calling of the event on event name for particular sender, for all the instances or for single instances, or activation. This is an example program, and this is step number 4. So this is our class LCL rental definition. So you can see here, this is the rental potential handler which is handling this event, triggering event. So this potential handler class will register the event handling. How it will do that? Class LCL rental, then definition. In the public section we will define another method, methods on vehicle created for event vehicle created of this one class, and then in the implementation part we will write down the line set handler me on vehicle created for all the instances. So what is the meaning of this one? Suppose this is car rental company, and these are the three triggering event, bus 1, bus 2 and truck 1. So when the vehicle is created at the location on vehicle created, this will be handled, this instance will be handled by this handler company. Similarly, if another vehicle is bus 2 is created at some location, then this will be handled by the car rental company. Similarly, if truck is created in any another location which is an instance, so for this one, this will handle by the car rental company. We can also use by giving the single instances there, but if we want to give at the same time all the instances, so we will use here the keyword for all instances. That means me means LCL rental class car rental company will handle all the instances. That means all the objects will be handled by this class. And when it will be handled? When the event is generated on vehicle created, then we will use the end method and then end class. Now come to the next topic, registration and deregistration handler methods, handler tables. Every object or the class that defines event has an internal table, and this table, internal table, is known as handler table. I'm again repeating here, every object or class that defines the event, so this triggering event which is defining the event has its own internal table, and this instance also have an internal table. Similarly, for this truck one has also its own internal table, and this internal table is called handler table. You can see this is a handler table of the bus one, and this all the handler methods that are registered on the various events are listed in the handler table. You can see in this figure, this is vehicle created, and for this bus one, this is a handler method. Handler method is registered vehicle, and this is a registered object which is pointing to the vehicle registration office. Similarly, this is a handler table for the bus two. It is containing two handler methods, add vehicle and register vehicle, and the reference is the object which is pointing to the two different handling classes, car rental as well as vehicle registration office. And we can also discuss here about the visibility section, the event handling, and we have again the visibility section 3, public, protected and private. So this was all about the lesson number 1 of the unit number 5. So starting with the lesson number 2 of the unit number 5, implementing events in local interfaces. In the previous lesson, we have discussed about the number of steps. There are 4 steps by which you can create the event programs into the ABAP editor. In the same way, we can also implement events in the local interfaces. The triggering and handling events are done in the same way as in the classes. Steps to implement the event handling for interfaces are as follow. The step number 1, define events in the interfaces, trigger interface event implementing classes, handle interface events, and register event handling. These are the same step that we follow in case of the local classes, and same step we are following in the local interface. I am again repeating the number of steps. The first one is we will define the events in the interface. Second, trigger interface events in implementing class. Third one, handle interface events. And finally, fourth one, register event handling. So these are the 4 basic steps that are followed in case of a local classes as well as in case of implementing event in a local interface. So this was all about the lesson number 2 of the unit number 5. Unit number 5 has been completed here. If you really like my videos, please press the like button and please subscribe to my channel for further videos.